Well, good morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you might be in time and space. I thought it was working. It was working. If you watched the last live stream that I did, the last half of it, the helicopters were working beautifully, perfectly. Everything was working just fine. So I was all happy getting ready to come back to this one, and I'm completely confident that it's going to work. And loaded it up, and right before I started broadcasting, I got in there to double check because it goes weird. And it seems to have went weird again. Maybe not with this one. With that little bell? Let's see. Alright, well, this one is acting stable. Sort of. Okay, maybe we are in good shape, and maybe it's just that bell, I'm not sure. But when I loaded the other one up, I wasn't getting anywhere. So if I can get this situated right quick, I'd really like to use that bell. The little tiny one with the big bubble, I'll show you. It has been really wonky for me. And when I tried using this one the last time, I just couldn't figure out how to get the helicopters to work. And, again, finally got it. Now I'm excited because I really want to do the Neofly freelance helicopter stuff. Search and rescue or whatever. But the search and rescue ones for sure. And also, and I haven't done it in a long time. There's a way to, every day there's a new challenge to go find some gold someplace. And without helicopters working, it's really difficult to get in and out of places to go get gold. So anyway, let's see how this one does. I don't even have my headphones on yet. It's always something, man, the Murphy's Law. Right off the bat, a spin. And it's moving. All right, trying to set rudder trim. And it's still pushing. Wind? Assist a tail rotor, that would probably help. It's on. Frustrating. Well, before I didn't mess with anything too much, let's try the little blue one. Man. Have to, double check something in YouTube real quick. Hope you're having a great day. I'm having a fantastic day. A bit tired. Pulled an all-nighter last night. So much to do. So. Today was would also be a, if things go wrong and you're tired, why you shouldn't fly when you're tired. So far, I'm in pretty good shape. All right. Nice. Easy. Yeah, that's what it was normally doing to me. With spin out of control. So what's that all about? Oh man, oh man, oh man. AI auto trim. Auto rudder. Not really helping me out though. I mean, I need to learn how to use it, but it does. That helped. But man, coming down. Trying to see if I can trim it better. All right. Well, maybe we have it. Getting views locked in. Okay. Okay. But now we have to be on the ground and off. Wow. In there, huh? Wait till it's below 180. Still don't see this going down. I don't get it. We're there. Yeah, it's man. A lot to do. All right. Well, now getting Neofly loaded and going to see about helicopter job. What's missing? Pretzel's missing. No music. Man, the last couple of days, been trying out different stations. A page worth of copyright claims. Two pages, two different streams, and each one more than 10 copyright claims against it. I think the other one was 17. I'll have to check. I think it's more than that, actually. Yeah, like emergency and search and rescue. Come on. Pop up on the screen. Where are you? Not sure why it changed instances. Yeah, like search and rescue and emergency. This number. The Harrisville Road out here.
Transporter from dispatch. Mayday, mayday, mayday. We have an urgent search and rescue mission. Rush to your aircraft.
Rush.
Transporter, we have received the distress beacon signal. Head to the last known position.
Do-do-do-do. Okay. Do that is. Okay, sorry, I had a phone call. Plasma.
Injections.
looks good from where I'm sitting. Taxi to the runway and take off.
What am I not getting? Thank you. Lord Almighty. So sorry that this is, I feel just so stupid. Well, that's new. Last week, every time I chose a job, a freelance job, and then I had to reset or do anything, it would blow the job out. So we're in good shape. Thank you. Ah, darn it.
Thank you.
Wow. A lot to get used to. Crazy. It is crazy keeping this thing perfectly balanced. It is rather difficult. Uh-oh. Very tricky, sir. I can't make the thing go straight. Forward. And stay going forward without turning or twisting or... to have something to reset things. getting closer. Ooh. All right. Where are we at? 30 minutes after the hour. All right, I've got to find out. If they're what the sensitivities are supposed to be. Let's see what they say about power management. Okay, options. Fighting is easy, you just need to switch to trim. Increase rotor trim. Longitudinal, increase rotor trim. Okay. Two entries for set rotor longitudinal trim. These act as a way to reset both trims independently. By hitting set. Here is asking about these. A lot of folks have been using curves with several degrees of success. Here's the thing, I don't use them myself and I don't believe there's a cookie cutter solution. Curves influence controls and how the helicopter behaves based on their setup, but different controls should be set up differently for the same helicopter. This means that a thrust monster, blah, 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 blah. Even with the same joystick, the helicopter may be small differences. My advice, I feel like you do need use curves, I recommend you adjust it to what your needs are. But I know it's lousy advice, right? Back to the solution for this lies within your needs. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Well, thank you for that, man. Try this website. That's the same guy. Had to change modern flight to legacy. Back again. That didn't help.
transporter. You are now entering the search zone. Use the beacon signal to locate any survivors.
Why does it snap it all the way back up? Just one touch. He wants some search and rescue, and as we get closer, the beacon is supposed to beep more frequently. Thank you. Well, this is more difficult than I recall.
Job. We now have the coordinates to send help. If there is somewhere suitable, please land to help the evacuation. That was close.
Oh,
wait
no.
Here until the evacuees are safely on board.
After all that, and I come down hard. Oh, Nemesis Chicken is in the chat room. Good morning, Captain. Good morning, good morning, good morning. 49 minutes after the, and then I crashed. But yeah, I'm getting the hang of it. Yeah, you got me all inspired, and then I said I wanted to try to get doing some of these search and rescues. Tell me you're able to hear the music. It's just so loud in my ears that it's inconceivable that you're not hearing it at this level. And if so, were you able to hear it at all? I mean, just even if it's just lightly in the background. Just barely audible. Okay, two. Good. Two's fine. See? I don't really like going much more. Where you had me at the other day, which is fine. Where you... it's so loud, and I don't know how to... At the moment, I don't know how to separate audio channels and just turn it down in my headphones. Let's see here. See the output level there. Be right back in a moment with the Yeah, I see it's nerfing the sound. All right, one more minute, please. We'll be right back. Humbaba. See, when I turn on my headphones, the audio output, it starts connecting to everything else and links to everything else. So I can't just, at the moment, just turn down the headphones without it messing with everything else. Oh well. I'll figure it out one of these days. Oh. Okay, 5 out of 10. Okay. I still haven't entirely figured out this helicopter stuff, man. It's constant adjusting to keep the thing balanced. I definitely need to watch videos on understanding how to fly in a helicopter, because it's a trip. All right. Okay, so once I am loaded in there, then it'll give me the option to pick another one. I think we still got paid for that. Yeah, we did, I think. We weren't able to assist in the rescue, but we successfully did it. Top of the hour. Now I have to turn the music down. 34%. All right, it's supposed to be ducking. Like when I mean, I have the setting right, but when I talk, it's supposed to dynamically start turning everything down. Kind of like in Sam Broadcaster, when you start talking, it has the ability to lower all the music in the background. And I've been trying to get that set right. Man, that's a long one. Emergency 21 miles to Monument Hill, the hill I talked about that's difficult and causes accidents. All the way to Monument, huh? 21 miles, firefighter 16. There's one that's 19. Oh man, but we'd have to go over 14,000 feet for that one. We'll have to do this short one here. Back over to the zoo. Alright, let's see if we can get it.
Hey pilot, glad you could help with this job. I have some tourists that would like to take some photos as you circle the point of interest. Pilot from dispatch. Tourists are ready to board now. Did you bring your camera? All the guests are on board. The weather looks perfect for photos.
Everything looks good from where I'm sitting. All right. I'll do this short run across town. And then if you're going to stick around, Hans, then I'll, I watched a couple of videos on using the glider. Didn't get any practice time in, but got a little bit more knowledge. Can't say I'm gonna do any better. We didn't start. No, we didn't start at all. Helicopter that Asobo gave us. Oh no. How's that happening? Yep, having problems trying to figure out this. Lord. I'm at KCOS. So I gotta fly right over to that mountain again and hover around the Will Rogers Shrine. It is a really delicate thing here, I'm noticing with this. Yes, if it comes in. Yes. Will Rogers was a humorist. Yeah, he was a cowboy. He was a writer and a humorist. I'll get the Bush Talk radio audible thing for it to play when we get there. Dads. Thank you. Getting there, almost there. Doing so well. If I pop the oh boy, this one again. Uh-oh. What are you doing? Oh, I've done something wrong. Now I'm just slowly falling. Oh, what the hell did I do? I'm gonna lock in the settings. I don't know what happened there. Huh. All of a sudden I kinda lost all power. That's weird. I didn't I'm not seeing you as a friend. Maybe I'm... Yeah, I didn't check the gas. You see how she's not going up? Maybe it is fuel. I don't know. Don't know what I could have done. Don't have a low fuel light. What in the world? A broker, sir. Let me go back to the main menu because I'm not getting, I'm not seeing you as online there, Hans, and I didn't get a friend request. So, let me go back to the main menu and check my options. But I don't believe I've changed anything since the last one. Multiplayer's on. Pardon? All players. I don't know how that got switched on. This time I'm going to take off from Let me turn down the music a moment here. And go to that Bush Talk Radio thing. I'll just play it. And that way you can find out who Will Rogers is. Was. It should see me as logged in. Aha. One moment. You probably have a black screen. It's flipped out on that one too. Bum, 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 bum. Everything's gone crazy. Well, that's weird. It used to be here for sure. And now it's not here anymore. I don't see it. There's Garden of the Gods, but they've taken Will Rogers' shrine out. What round it? No clouds. Okay, that's something else I'm going to do. Yeah, it's weird. I only see X Ministry as being online local players. Turn down that. Bring him down. It's that Kinneas clone that's getting the requests. Yeah, but I don't see him online. I can't send him a request, right? So if I come back here and go up to friends, you're not seeing that. 1 second, the damn Bush Talk thing again. Why that does that? I don't know. That's a really crappy bug. Now it doesn't want to go away. What the hell? Unbelievable. Now that thing's blocking the screen, I can't get rid of it. Oh my lord. This is getting ridiculous. Sorry. This Bush Talk radio screen won't go away. Son of a bitch. I have to just kill Microsoft Flight Simulator and make it start again. Okay, and maybe that'll help me see Hans now. I don't know what's wrong with the thing, so might as well kill it, start over again. Okay, so one of the things I learned about gliding is that you really do want to have some clouds in the sky because clouds create thermals. So on the underside of clouds that are dense, that have a dark bottom and a flat bottom and a big poofy top, they said thermals are generating underneath those, right? So they said clouds are your friends when you're gliding. And so what I was doing there is I was trying to set the weather and set a cloud layer and a wind layer to bring the clouds closer down towards the mountains, to the tops of the mountains, so that we had some sort of thermal action going on. And also you get thermals the closer you are to the side of a mountain before you crest it, potentially. So by starting at KFCS at the Army Air Base, we're just a stone's throw away from Cheyenne Mountain. And then, yeah, so, yeah, this would be a great time for that. So whether I send out the invite, or Han sets out the invite, or wherever he wants to spawn from, maybe we can set the cloud layers that way to give me a little bit of advantage. I know it, you're supposed to be able to do it no matter what. As we saw the other day, Hans had no problem flying in the same area as me, but I think I'm going to need a little bit more help. All right, I also learned a little bit more about, I got the refresher on that, the ribbon that's on the front of your windshield. And that when it's tilting to one side, you want to use opposite rudder to try to balance yourself out so that that ribbon is mostly trying to stay straight. So that's one thing you want to try to do. And then other than that, that's really all I'm hearing is dump the ballast before landings. And I didn't really read anything or see anything, anybody really talking too much about how to use the speed brake. And I didn't see anybody covering any aerobatic moves in the glider. So they, one thing I did learn about is that its propensity when it turns to dip one wing harder than the other, which can throw it into an uncontrolled spin. But there seems to be a way to leverage that, as Han seems to be able to do, as he's able to throw himself upside down and change direction, like spinning on a dime. So he's able to use that spin and then flip around. Okay. I'm back in. There's Hans. Invite to group. Okay. Starting at KFCS. All right, 28 minutes after the hour. Yeah, I missed it. Man, time is moving. Oh, check this out. Also, I've heard about it. I've never used it. Look at this. Nemesis chicken. Thermals. Now I can't control the wind layer. What's going on? That's weird, but the thermals are on. Oh, crap, what are you not seeing now? Oh Jesus Christ, now the sky for sim servers. Just had thermals a minute ago. Yeah, ready enough. Yep, ready, I guess. This was the There's the gear. Go. He's already up there, taking off, and I'm already falling behind. But we have a thermal. I should be actually climbing. No, no, I'm not. No. No. Yeah, it's gonna be another one of those days. Dump the ballast. Oof. Yep. I'm not understanding how that rudder thing is working to keep the thing, the ribbon there. Look at that. He's just cruising away. Oh, you know what? My controls aren't set for a glider. They're set for the helicopter. No, 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 no. Didn't like that at a bit. Son of a gun. Look at all that wind over there. Son of a bitch. I can't even get to it. There goes that tipping of the wing again. Coordinated turns, man. Learning how to... So yeah, they said because the wings are like that, when you do a turn, you apply a little too much pressure, the wing will immediately dip. Alright, Hans, you have a great day. Give it one more shot. We don't have any goddamn thermals now. I'm gonna be so mad. There. If I don't catch any wind now, I'm gonna be so mad. Creating typhoon thermals. I watch, I still won't be able to glide. Right. boat. Oh, that's somebody else. Oh. Yes. I'm gonna go ahead and disconnect from him now. I don't know. I don't know if Hans uses thermals at all. I mean, should be able to do it audibly. Should have to fly towards it. Try keeping the nose the toe plane on your instruments. Thank you. Yeah, he's real good, man. He's so impressive. The speeds he's getting. I'm not certain. Tipping again. I met Hans a couple of days ago, and he said he was in a glider flying. And so this is some of the first glider flying I've done. Let me turn this down. Just turn it off for a minute so I can actually hear the tone. No, I don't have any experience at all. But Hans showed up the other day again. He says he's a glider. He likes flying gliders. So I said, well, heck, man, let's try to do some. But he's not very impressed. Right. Oh, okay, great. Yeah, he's amazing. He's amazing. I just, even with the thermals there, I swear, I'm just struggling to stay afloat. Yeah. I'll be darned. That's great. That's awesome. We have there. We had a pitch change. Oh. Very difficult. See the yellow triangle at around 100 kilometers. Let's get in on the screen here. The yellow triangle. Oh, I see. The yellow triangle the orange triangle there. Oh. Whoa. Crazy. I'll show you there. It's the airspeed indicator. That's what I'm thinking. Right? How do we turn off this the audible thing? I'm gonna bring the clouds all the way to the ground at this point. Oh. All right, so let's take a look at that. But we're increasing. Oh, yeah, yeah. So that right there. Roger, Kinneas 2-1. Yes, it does do lightning. Let me turn off the thermals. What's the white ring? Yeah, that's better. All right, best rate of climb. Right in there. It's an airspeed indicator, right? Man. Oh, that was promising there for a second. A half second. The big boop, boop, boop. The half circle thing tells you both. So the little red diamond, should I be chasing the little red diamond like that and trying to keep my angle of attack on the red diamond? What's, and then there's the blue triangle, and then this yellow bar down here, it does it gets smaller and larger, so I need to learn how to use this instrument better. So that's me trying to just chase the red dot. And if I look up at the top wind speed, yeah, right when I'm on it, there's the best rate to climb right there, it says. Or it's on the triangle now. Wow, I can't imagine, well, I can, eventually getting to the point where you can do this by touch. You don't rely on instruments. I mean, that means it's completely, you can just feel the plane, you know what's going on. So by the way, you're trimmed out when you first take off. You can tell where the wind is going. Well, this is certainly a trip. I'm not using trim. I'm trying to hold the wheel up. As soon as I let any pressure off the nose, there she goes. See how she's dropping? So I'm trying to hold it. I'm trying to hold it right there on that triangle. I try to put some trim in, so if I release the joystick a little bit, that was, wow, some big lightning. Okay, so there's a little bit too much trim, now it's a little high. I don't know, it's a little low. Come back up. Pull the nose up. All right, so they're the... All right, so that's the joystick. I'm trying to trim it the best I can. Yeah, the original flight simulator. My dad had it. I had it. But the knowledge base, the computer was primitive. I didn't understand anything. I didn't understand the training. And so it was more like, oh, this is fun. I can fly around. But then the graphics are crappy. And then I didn't know how to land and didn't know how to do anything. And then they released Microsoft Flight Simulator 2000, and I had that. My dad had that. Same kind of thing. Couldn't stick any landings, and so I just used it for kind of like looking around, but the graphics weren't spectacular, so, you know, I just gave it up. And then they released Flight Simulator 10. Well, then they released Flight. And, well, or one of the other first. Flight Simulator X, and then Flight. And it was Flight that I got the icon. And I started learning how to land, and then I got excited about wanting to learn. So then I started absorbing everything in the knowledge base in Flight Simulator 10. And after I got through everything and finally was able to accomplish everything in Flight Simulator 10 in the knowledge base, then... YouTube was finally around, and then I could spend all day long watching flight training videos. And, yeah, and here we are. Oh, I've been asking them and begging them and pleading them to please bring back Microsoft Combat. And... there are some people that work over there that are staunch. I don't want to get too political, but they absolutely, when you even mention bringing up combat, they lose their minds. Big capital letters, it will not have combat. But with the very first release, when I was in the alpha of this thing, and they released the first paperwork on the control settings, you had all your weapon settings, so I've been hopeful the whole time that they'll bring back Microsoft Flight Simulator Combat. But now they keep saying, we're not going to bring it back, we're not going to do it, we're not going to do it. And I really want them to do it, because I'd really like to continue using this simulator instead of having to go over to DCS World. Although DCS World is like the primo when it comes to... combat. It's dropping off if I turn that way. That was nice in there. There's my home airport out there. I hope so. I really do. I'm thinking too small. In what way? Microsoft Combat Space Fight Simulator? They haven't got the Spaceship Simulator yet. Starship Simulator? Star Citizen? Yeah, but still... I mean, because it's Star Citizen, it's still... automated. Everything's automated. Right? I mean... you're not flying. It's not a... if you'd like, you go to your local airport. EDWU. EDWU. Yeah, all the buttons work, but yeah, I suppose you're right. And in a lot of, I remember really struggling with the controls there. There were so many of them. E D W U. Nine right or 27 left? 27 left. Oh, but it's dark right now over there. Why can't I set the time of day? Turn that off. There we go. Time for a quick little smoke break. Yeah, we're in. Yeah, he said he taught Hans. I have a Sidewinder joystick that has the twist rudder control. Unfortunately, no foot pedals. That's weird, it keeps playing the Nutcracker Suite. It is the season for sure. So the speed brake, okay, that's another thing they mentioned. Turn this back down. They said when you're listening to the tone and you're trying to keep the ribbon straight and you need to do a small, tight turn to find the right thermal, they said use the speed brake. So you can turn in a much more coordinated manner. I had one right there. Brr, slow turning. Oh, that's what I'm just going with what the video said. The video said when you're trying to hunt down a thermal, like right now, I'm shooting for the tone and the ribbon for a straight line. I'm kind of on it now. But they said hit the speed brake so you can turn much slower. And then with the ribbon thing, the guy in the video said, okay, so let's say the ribbon is going hard to the right. He's saying apply opposite rudder. So you applied left rudder to try to straighten the ribbon out. I don't know. I'm learning. I don't know the right answers. I'm taking all the answers that I can get and putting them to the test in here. And I turned off the speed brake now. I mean, it's off now. So with regard to the ribbon, yeah, all I know now is, and I don't really understand that. I mean, I kind of get it, that you want to keep the ribbon straight. But how can you possibly keep the ribbon straight? So, okay, so if it's deflecting like right now, I mean, how do you know? They can't decide what it wants to do, left and right. Yeah, PPP. If we drop the ballast now, will we fly farther? Shh. The gear was up. It's very pretty here. Love green. Yeah. Very pretty. Uh-huh. Look at that. Right under the tree. The only... She... All right. I would really like to know. The year up. No, I think the jet stream stays constant. I think. But yeah, the time of day, the heat on the ground. Let's see. So later in the day, right? Should be the hottest. Like now. Or midday. Let's see. KGSP. I wonder what Sedona, Arizona would be like. It's always super hot. It gets so dangerous. It gets so hot. It gets so hot in Arizona that sometimes planes aren't allowed to land. It's generating such thermal uplift that it makes it impossible to land. And I know that sounds really silly, but in my experience, in the simulator anyway, when flying in the hottest days in Arizona and I try to land the plane, it floats. I can't make it come down. Okay. KGSP. Sorry, that's 3 a.m. Right, that is one thing that I did hear about, that clouds are your friends in a glider, especially the ones that have the darker bottom, clouds that have a higher density and a darker bottom and a fluffier top. They said those are your best friends. No, I got that from a video. flying small, shallow circles. Oops. Yeah, that's what they're saying. Fly small circles so you can listen to your little audio indicator. Like right now, kind of picking up a little bit. Getting louder. Oh. Oh, I see. I see what you're saying. This is your nearest airport nemesis. Head west. Well, with the I'm not. I'll just say no. All I can think of is that would be the application of nose one direction and complete opposite rudder in another direction. So you keep your nose going in the right direction, but you're crabbing. Or maybe that's a different thing. And I hate bringing this thing to a close. I really do. It's almost 2 o'clock. Yeah, so 4-hour live stream. And that's about as much as I should be doing. So, as much as I want to continue, all good things must come to an end. I think I will go ahead and at tomorrow to try to rig keyboard rudder commands instead of using, I mean, I can continue to use the joystick in the twist fashion, but I'm thinking about what you're talking about and setting up the keyboard for rudders so that I control it that way instead of using the twist, and that way I can do the, because normally anytime I do any sort of movement whatsoever with the joystick, I'm somehow or another always applying a left or right twist or in a turn or whatever. So if you're too high on approach, you cross aileron and rudder. Right, so let's say I'm turning to the left and I would apply a bunch of right rudder, right, to throw the ass end around. Get to the chop. You want to, okay. No, I... Well, I'll have to do the chopper tomorrow. I have to end the live stream. Let me turn this off here. Put up the right screen. Well, it's working. The only thing that's not working was me. So, if nothing's going on tomorrow, I may not have any work this whole freaking week, which is sad. But, hey, when people are having medical problems, you know, the boss is having problems, and there's no work. What can I do? But can't cry about it. So, just sitting here trying to make a buck doing some of these live streams. So, again, if nothing's going on tomorrow, same bat time, same bat channel. And we'll pick it up there and see how we do. See you tomorrow. do, 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 do.